Very warm welcome to WS Cube Tech. So guys, in our previous session, we have covered how to delete or insert any element inside a numby array. In our today's session, we'll be talking about arithmetic operations that we have with our numbys. So to apply these arithmetic operations, first of all, we will import numby as np. Once we have imported numby as np, we'll be creating an array over here by writing arr is equals to np.array. And I'll be passing a list over here of a few elements. Let's say I have 20, 30, 40, 50. And or let's take it as some small elements. Let's say I'll take 2, 3, 4, 5. And another array over here, arr1 is equals to np.array. And here I'll be passing some more elements. That's let's say 1, 3, 5, 7. Okay, what do I need to do now? I need to apply the addition operation over here. For that, I'll be simply writing print arr plus arr1. And if we run it, let's see what output we'll get. So we'll be getting 2 plus 1 as 3, 3 plus 3 as 6, 4 plus 5 as 9, and 5 plus 7 as 12 over here. Similarly, if you want to subtract them, in that case, you can just write minus over here. And as soon as you run it, you'll be getting the subtraction of both the arrays, that 2 minus 1 is 1. 3 minus 3 is 0, 4 minus 5 is minus 1, and 5 minus 7 is minus 2 here. Similarly, if you apply multiplication operator over here, you will get the output in this way, that you have 2 times 1 is 2, 3 times 3 is 9, 4 times 5 is 20, and 5 times 7 is 35. And lastly, we have a division operator here. So let's try division. So division over here will give us 2 divided by 1 is 2, 3 divided by 3 is 1, 4 divided by 5 is 0.8. Similarly, 5 divided by 7 is 0.71. Just like how our simple arithmetic operations can be applied, we can also apply floor division here. The floor division will give us the quotient when the first array will be divided by the second array. That means 2. When 2 is divided by 1, the quotient is 2. When 3 is divided by 3, the quotient is 1. When 4 is divided by 5, the quotient is 0 over here. Because if I write 4, 4 when divided by 5. In that case, what would happen? We need to take a decimal value over here, and as soon as the decimal comes, the value will become 0 here. Similarly, 5 when divided by 7 will also give us 0 here. Just like how we can write the floor division, we can also write the modulus. For modulus, we write the percentage symbol, and as soon as we run it, we'll get the output as 0045, that when 2 when divided by 1 gives the remainder 0, 3 divided by 3 gives the remainder 0. 4 divided by 5 gives the remainder 0, 5 divided by 7 gives the remainder 0. And lastly, we can also try the power as well. So for power, I'll be writing double asterisk symbol. And you can just use some other elements here. So 2, 3, 2. Okay. And I'll be closing it inside the square brackets. And it's, as soon as I run it, I'll get the output. 2 raised to the power 1 is 2. 3 raised to the power 2 is 9. 4 raised to the power 3 is 64, and 5 raised to the power 2 is 25. In this way, we can also obtain the power here. So these are what? These are basic simple arithmetic functions. Now this is about 1D. What if there is 2D? In 2D also, we can apply the similar methods. So let me just make it 2D here. And same goes for 3D as well. So you can apply the similar methods, similar operations on 3D as well. So we'll be applying them on 3D. Once I'll just convert them into 2D first. Okay. So let's start with the addition again. So I'll be putting addition and arr plus arr1. So in this way, what we'll be getting? So 2 plus 1 is 3 over here. 3 plus 2 is 5. 4 plus 3 is 7 in this row. And 5 plus 2 is 7 over here. In this way, we are getting the output. That means it's matching with the elements here. Okay. Similarly, our subtraction work. So if I run it. So 2 minus 1. Would be 1, 3 minus 2 would be 1, 4 minus 3 would be 1, and 5 minus 2 would be 2. And then we have multiplication operator. So dot multiplication, we are not talking about the matrix multiplication here, but the simple multiplication with each element. So 2 times 1 is 2, 3 times 2 is 6, 4 times 3 is 12, and 5 times 2 is 10 over here. Similarly, the division works, and all the other operators also works in the similar way. That we have 2 when divided by 1 is 2, 3 when divided by 2 is 1.5, 4 when divided by 3 is 1.3 is something, and 5 when divided by 2 is 2.5. So in this way, you can obtain the output by using the multidimensional array as well. So I hope guys that all the basic arithmetic operations over here are clear to you. In our next session, we'll be talking about the arithmetic functions that are inside our numpy arrays. So stay connected guys, and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.